everyone, welcome back to the channel. Hope you're keeping well. Hope you're enjoying the content that we're sending out. Another quick swing video this week just to talk over something you may have on your mind if you're a swayer or slider in your golf swing. Why does it happen? How can we put it right? And a bit of a difference in this video this time. I'm going to analyse a couple of swings that I'm making, one with a fault, one on how you should do it, and talk through maybe how you can use your video camera when you're at the practice range or even in the garden next time, and how you can identify and get on top of it. So sway or slide, you know, how do you know which one you are? How do you know what to look for? Have you seen your swing on camera with your coach before? Have you videoed it yourself? Has someone just commented it to you on the golf course? How do you know what you're looking for? So for me, I'm a right-handed golfer. As I move away from the boys, I move, you know, to my right-hand side or begin my takeaway. As I move back, a lower half lateral move to away from the target line here would indicate to me a sway. And then on the way down, as I move into the hitting position, a lower half lateral movement towards the target. As I move, I slide towards the target. There's my slide. So I want to focus a little bit now on sway. We're going to look at some swings, as I said earlier on, that I've made that can maybe clear up a couple of things there with sway. Also want to look at how you could look at it on camera yourself and maybe a couple of exercises you could do to get on top of it.
So let's get to work on this sway. If we have a look at the good looking gentleman on the left, we can see that the setup position is for a 7-iron. Ball position is quite central. I've stuck a line in both drawings from the ankle bone, just outside the ankle bone, through the hip line. What I want to watch for in the left picture is how I break through that line and sway and end up in a position where you can see my knees the other side of the line now. So what that's done, that's stacked quite a bit of weight on my right side, and the chances of me making good impact or controlling my low point now are pretty slim, and I'm probably going to lose power if I do make connection. I'm probably going to add loft to the golf club as well, so not the strongest position in the world. Now if we nip over to the right hand side, let's have a little look. Same line, decent turn, and you can see now I've turned onto the inside of the line, slightly stronger angle, none of the leg has breached the line, very centered, very stable, quite powerful and quite easy for me to hit down on the golf ball from that position. Arms are a little bit narrow, but that's something I'm working on in my own golf swing. Quite an interesting point here, if I zip back with both positions, just look about the amount of movement because of the lower half with the head. If I just move this one and I look at the ping sign behind in the background on our slat wall for our fitting equipment, watch how much my head moves past that ping sign. I can actually see the P there because of my lower half. I look, nip over to the right, much more stable, can hardly see any of the P on the ping sign there. So that's maybe something to watch out for if you're videoing your own swing. Is there a reference point in the background maybe that allows you to see where there's been any upper body movement because of the lower half? But hopefully that gives you an idea of maybe something that you can look for. This is a simple program that I've downloaded on my phone and my iPad to use for my coaching. There's plenty of good things out there, but you might use a ruler or a book, or you might get yourself a bit of coaching, basic coaching software, and just start to stick a few lines on and work on this. Hopefully that helps.
So how can you practice and get away from that swaying movement? You know, maybe that's the thing that's been hurting your ground strike, hurting your impact on the floor, maybe making you hit the ball a bit higher because you're scooping as a result of it. So a quick little exercise. I mean, at the range, or if you had someone there you were working with, you might be able to get them to hold a stick on the side of your body or a club or something to just make you aware of the movement. The camera's brilliant as well. Just one you can do at home or at the range. I've set my golf bag up right next to me as I address and set up there. Hopefully you can see that okay. And I'm going to take my address position. Quite difficult to hit shots doing this, but you know, I've got it right up against the edge of the side of my leg there on my thigh. And as I move away from the ball, I can really feel, as I turn, I can feel that I'm just coming back on the inside of it slightly. I'm not touching or pushing against it, which is a really good indicator of the sway. If I move that lower half and start to sway, I can hear all the clubs rattling, I can hear everything, feel the bag moving as well. It's a good one to work on if you've got a bit of time in the garden here, just to try and get that feeling. I'll try and hit one and not make the clubs move. Quite difficult to move through the golf ball, but definitely felt there that I was a lot more centered as I turned into my backswing. I felt having the object there as well made me aware that I didn't want to move my lower half away from the target. So that might be a good one to work on at home and get some practice in the garden or when we get back to golf ranges. So I hope that video was helpful. If you've identified yourself as a bit of a swayer and you know you picked up some interesting pieces there, that's great. Get to work on it. Use the tips I've given you there in the video. Start to get your swing on video if you're not already. And then obviously when you can, get to your PGA coach to help you out with it. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. And obviously if you're not a subscriber, if you could subscribe, that would be appreciated. And keep well and see you all soon.